Muck was going to fly at the back. Up he goes! Oh, yes!
What a historic victory. Monfrees has kicked a goal. Unbelievable.
Can he go again? Josh Dickens, JJ! Another extraordinary showdown. Flashpoint, Stevie Motlop. What a time! Oh! Oh! He is floating on air now. The siren sounds. The sweet siren for Port Adelaide.
It is Ross the Boss time, and Ross, I remember Kevin Sheedy saying to us, Anzac Day, such a big game, it is worth eight games of regular home and away football. The experience you get, to play on that one big day in front of 100,000 people. Talk us through what it's like when you're playing against the West Coast Eagles, two-team town, and the pressure of that build-up.
Well, the leading footage tells you what it's like. It's like a civil war. Yeah. Like, their hair was raising on the back of their neck then. So, talk about motivating players, just play that pre-game and send them down the race. Like, big-time football, nowhere to hide. And the town's split in two. And it's a massive build-up in the press, typically press conferences, a lot of chatter around the office. And you want to do... It's two tribes go to war. That's really as best I can describe it.
I cannot wait for this game. You've got two different coaches, one very experienced in Ken Hinckley versus Matthew Nix, who'll coach his second game. But Ken Hinckley, he's been under a fair bit of pressure over this off-season. How do you think that experience counts in
well,
Ken Hinckley's
well, in Kenny we yeah. trust. When yeah. he burst onto the scene there, they had immediate success. Then it's been a bit drier. Yeah. So he's come out and said, we're in it to win it. So finals or bust, and he's looking for an extension as well. I really rate Kenny. Mm. I think he's the man for the job, and I think he can deliver. Mm. But he's got the experienced hands just to get him to the line when the ball bounces, ready to go.
How much of a factor is that with no crowds, Ross?
I think it's huge. Mm. It is huge. That players perform and they want to be recognised. But I was watching a bit of footage of Adelaide-Sydney round one. I just loved what Papley did. He kicked the goal and he just went over to the crowd and high-fived them all like they're there. So players are going to have to create and bring their own energy to get each other up. And we saw round one, teams that did it well. Collingwood did it well. Richmond did it well. And we saw a flat Western Bulldogs. So you don't want to be flat in a showdown.
Just on the Adelaide Crows... No one really expects too much of them this year, but I want to get your thoughts on what the coach Matthew Nix had to say about how they want to play this year under him.
A win for us is seeing some of our training come through. You know, some of our contest work that we've really put time into, some of our team defence. You know, they're our two key focus areas.
Word out of Adelaide is that they'd pretty much coached 90% team defence over the off season.
Yeah, well, that seems a little bit extreme, but he's really telling his players. I value contest and I value pressure and team defence, and that's what we're going to measure ourselves on. So he needs to deliver on that and his squad needs to deliver for him.
Ross, here were the stats in round one and you had some concerns for the Adelaide Crows.
Yeah, well, if you're Adelaide Crows, so we heard... And look, in fairness, one game, he's got time and it's been COVID, but he needs to deliver and they've got some work to do. So the comp averages are on the far right for our viewers. So plus or minus 12 contested ball, they're minus 17, and that is a smacking in that area. That's where the game starts, gets the ball going your way. And you can see Port Adelaide were the exact opposite. So they're going to run into a team in red hot form. Uncontested marks, the ability to control the ball, which is the modern game, and then go in. The comp average was 65. They were half of that. So when they had the ball, when they did win it, they couldn't find any time or space. So that would be a red alert, and maybe that is a reflection of we didn't do enough offensive work. When you think of the Crows at their best, open it up, lengthen, get it in between and go. So, but they did score okay. But you think if our focus was contest and our focus was defence and defending the turnover, the comp average is 40. They were 20% above at 50, the comp average. But they're going to run into a red-hot Port Adelaide if they can maintain it.
Ross, just on that, Port Adelaide, you were very impressed with their performance. I know it was the Gold Coast Suns, but... They bought the heat.
Well, it doesn't matter. Yeah. There are no easy games in AFL footy, particularly up on the Gold Coast. It's a challenging environment. So they smacked contested ball. And as we saw that footage, there was a lot of pressure. Motlop, big tackle, Rosie's pace, and a young key forward. And you just see Port Adelaide go in, key forward chasing out, pressure's on them. They really chase them down, force the turnover, numbers, but then their ability. Rosie with the skill and the decision-making to go back in and a young, exciting key forward in Georgiardi. So Adelaide are up for a massive challenge in a showdown. So Kenny Hinckley's game plan is embedded and so it should be. Matty Nix got some work to do, but he'll be looking for a response.
And you've identified an area where you think, I think, Adelaide a week, and maybe Port Adelaide can expose them.
Yeah, and it's the noise around Adelaide and their football club. Last year, they thought their tall forwards were a bit... There was too many of them and a little bit slow. So if you look at it, they've got Taylor Walker, Billy Frampton, Young 200, 193, Tommy Lynch and Fogarty. So they're going to play a mobile Port Adelaide back line. So if they're not marking the ball, it's swept out there pretty quickly. I wouldn't say any of them feature on the chase down stakes. Okay. So hopefully Matty Nix plays this clip.
Port Adelaide by how much?
Oh, I think they win by 5 goals.
I'm with you.
Lordy, line in the sand for Adelaide, surely, even after McLeod's utterings in the last 24 hours?
Oh, they need to. It's probably just want to see their brand, really. I think they'll be a bottom four club this year, though, the Adelaide Crows, starting all over again.